Hi everybody, so I'll be talking on application that we built known as IRCB. So IRCB is a IRC Bouncer, and we implemented it, we want to implement it as a IRC Bouncer as a service. So before starting off with the talk, so let me introduce myself. So I am Sayan Chowdhury, I am from India, and I work with the Fedora Engineering Team as a Fedora Infrastructure Engineer. And this is my Twitter handle, GitHub URL, and my email ID. So let me give you a background of the talk. So we started off with a project called Varta. Varta is an Indic word which means to talk in Hindi. And the aim was to build an open communication and a collaboration tool for humans, so that on top of open protocols, right? So we chose IRC as our platform, and we also had a prototype working on. We built it on Meteor.js, and we ran it for 1 year, and then last year we had to stop it, and because we hit some issues because of its monolithic code base. And since it was a prototype, we and Meteor.js was also in its development stage, and so we hit a lot of issues while writing code. And then issues were like we could not restart a part of that particular application, and we had to go for restarting the complete application as a whole. And also the maintaining connections with the server, IRC servers, was becoming painful in the long run. So so we chose to rework on this thing, and started off working with IRCB. So this is Varta. So we had we made a responsive UI on top of Bootstrap, Twitter Bootstrap, and it was working really good until it hit the issues which we faced last year. So why a bouncer? So bouncer is basically a proxy between your IRC client and your IRC server, which accepts all the traffic, and all the messages passes through that particular IRC bouncer. The IRC bouncer basically resides in a remote server which is always online, so that if you disconnect your IRC client, it can keep logging your messages and keep it's like a ghost for you on the internet. So but why another bouncer? So we did a couple of research while doing on bouncers, and we saw that there are a couple of bouncers like ZNC, but we did not want to reinvent the wheel. But we saw that the things which we needed was not there in the existing bouncers. Some was like multi-host bouncers. So if you know of in Freenode, so Freenode restricts your number of connections to 50, and if you want to increase that connections, you need to go through a long process. So instead, we thought of a multi-host system where suppose you get exhaust on a particular host, so it would automatically scale to another host. So this was a thing which we wanted for our bouncer. And then when the condition for multi-host comes in the scenario, the data synchronization between those bouncers get tough. So we also face this issue in the existing bouncers. And so there's no consumable and sane API for any of the bouncers. So all the current bouncers have API to at the max create a user or delete a network or anything like that on that level. But there's no way to control your browser at the whole. So we wanted something in which we a person can automatically create its own IRC client on top of that particular API. So we started writing a API on top of IRCB also. And most of the, if you start configuring ZNC, it's really tough to start configuration. So we wanted something that is easy to deploy, easy to configure, and easy to maintain. So these were the reasons for which we started off working with IRCB. So as I told you, we are basically Python fanboys, and since Python 3 is the is the latest version of Python right now. So we started building IRCB on top of Python 3. And we use async.io, a combination of async.io and Python 3 in IRCB. And the features that we want, since it's in the building process, so some features are to be implemented in next few months. So currently we have a distributed and auto scalable system in place. So whenever a particular host get exhausted, so we automatically try to scale it to another level, and if the if there is no need of that host, we try to scale down also at the same time. And so then we have a web CLI, we have web and a CLI to control your bouncer. It's not that great right now, but in the future it will be. So the CLI is pretty much good, but the web is we are working on the web part right now, so it would be good in next few weeks maybe. So we are planning for to do a release in next month. And right now it's really easy to manage, so you just need to fire a few commands and your bouncers is ready to go. And so consumable by external services. So we plan to have like so we plan to make that API. So that API I was talking about, so we are building an API on top of IRCB, so that using that API endpoints, the people outside people can actually build their own IRC client on the top of that particular API. So the architecture we planned is like this. So we have a lot of those are the IRC clients which actually connect to a load balancer. So the use of the load balancer is that it runs on an 80 or a 443 port. So it's helpful because it can be accessible from anywhere. And this scenario, we have seen that in many Indian colleges, the ports like the IRC port or the Git port is usually blocked. So in that scenarios, students actually find it helpful to connect to something on the internet itself on an 80 port. So we have a load balancer in place, and then we have this cluster of bouncers which actually connect to the IRC servers. And then we have the CLI through which an admin, a CLI and a web console through which an admin can actually add network, create users, and actually manage the bouncers. But if you see right now, so this is actually a data store which might not be visible properly. And so you might see that this bouncers, web console and CLI is kind of divided into components, but how do they actually communicate? So recently, if you have heard of Facebook, Facebook gave a new proposal on a framework called Flux. So basically, it's a unidirectional method, data flow. So they propose that there should be a unidirectional data flow. So whenever there is an action, the data passes to the dispatcher, and the data store is updated, and the data store actually emits out events based on which the view is re-rendered again. So we implemented a similar thing on the server side. So whenever a bouncer wants to connect to, suppose they want to update a network, so it makes an initialization call to the data store via the dispatcher. And once the data store is updated, it actually event signals to all the components, and the consumer which are actually listening to this particular events can actually work on those messages. And suppose they can disconnect a bot, update a bot, or do operations based on that particular event. So the current status is we did a 0.1 release recently, and we have a basic authentication support in which the IRC client can connect to this particular IRC bouncer which through an access token, and then we have support for multiple connections, multiple clients through the same IRC server. So if you connect through XChat or IRC, so it uses the same connections to connect to the IRC server. And then we have, like I told, we have a CLI in place. So it we are building on with the CLI also. So since it's a 0.1 release, we have a lot of scope in future. And let me explain like what's the way ahead. So as I told you, like free node restricts the number of connections from a particular IP. So after talking to the free node guys, they told that if you have an ident server, if you do identification, so we give a increased number of connections that you can do. So we are planning to build an ident server, and then this is currently we are implementing. Like I told, we are planning to implement a flux architecture on the server side, but this is actually done, which we have. which we will be releasing in 0.2 release, and auto scale to avoid maximum connections per limit IP limit. So this is basically dependent on ident server. So we will be, so once the ident server is done, we will be working on this third issue. So on the bigger picture, if you know, after IRCB is stable, we will be working on Varta again. And so that Varta will be use case, so IRCB will be use case for Varta. And if you know, Fedora is working on a communication tool for its Fedora contributors known as Fedora Hubs. So Fedora Hubs will be having an IRC widget through which all the real-time chat that is happening over the Fedora channels can be seen. So we are having a plan to integrate Fedora Hubs with IRCB in sometime future. So, so right now, we are, two of us are currently working on this project. So the more the hands, it would be better. So how can you join? So we are working on IRCB ground up. There are plenty of tasks to do. And this is the GitHub repo which we have. Under the Varta organization, you can look up for the issues on Varta on the IRCB repo and start contributing to it. We also have an IRC channel called Hash Varta, so you can come down and ping us there also. So my IRC nick is Sayan, so you can come down and ping me there. So yeah. So the free node channel is #Varta, the code rep is in Varta/IRCB, and we also have a mailing list for discussions which is on Google Groups. So you can join in there and post any questions that you have. So that's all from my side. So any questions? So I think I can end this talk. Thank you.